We thank you for the grace to be in your presence this evening. Our Father, we open our hearts unto you. Come and speak to us in this Bible study. King of kings, Lord of lords. We want to walk with you. We want to please you. We want to make heaven. Help us to be able to do all this. Today, O God, we want to hear your voice. Come and teach us how to hear your voice. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you and have a seat. I want to welcome all of us.
Thank you.
To this Bible study in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Our theme of study is hearing the voice of God. Hearing the voice of God. The study of today is number 6 in the series. Last week, we were on study number 5. When we started to look at the avenues of receiving the voice of God. So today's study is also going to be avenues of receiving the voice of God, part 2.
Vision.
What is vision? Vision can be defined As a supernatural insight into the realm of the spirit. A supernatural insight. Or let me put it this other way. It is a grace to see into the spirit realm. A man of God was in a place.
And you are not compelling to come.
They were in that place.
I went.
A woman was standing before him. Suddenly, the man of God can no longer see every other person present. The only person that he was seeing was the woman. But behind the woman was a board, a big board. Ability to see eye of the spirit.
Oye ipa lati le ri nkan ni party ni.
Beloved,
Olufe,
vision can take place in three instances.
Iran yi o si le waye ni orisi ona meta.
Three instances where vision can take place.
Orisi ona meta ati iran ti le ri waye ni.
Number one,
ona koko,
you are conscious.
Ni ti emo.
You are very conscious.
Tell me, and you know you will.
And you will see into the spirit realm.
Tell us why you know it. Tell me.
Number two.
On occasion.
You can also see into the spirit realm.
And you know you know it. Tell me.
When you are sleeping.
Ni ba te ba su lo du o.
And your eyes are closed.
Ti o lo you are ni di lo di.
So some people can receive vision in their sleep.
Ni to ti ama elu mi na le ba yin na.
Praise God.
And you are
number three instance where vision can come to you.
The money that toy died in your
is that you may be physically conscious.
And they were not you go by it.
You are not seeing them.
Tell us.
You just close your eyes.
Tell
you, did you? And you start to see something.
Tell us where you live.
It's as if you are praying.
You don't come to America and do that. Well,
your eyes are closed.
You are human and living.
And it's as if they just bring a television screen.
You don't have any care of it.
And you start to see things.
Else, then see you in person.
So, beloved, where you experience any of these things that I mentioned, they are not extraordinary.
In conscience,
they are part of the plan of God for His own children. So God has a plan to employ vision to speak His
own children.
Joel chapter 2,
verse
28. Joel chapter 2,
verse
28. Say, it shall come to pass afterwards that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And your old men shall drink drinks. And your young men shall see vision.
One day again, don't you know, they will
be able to see vision. So if the young ones are seeing vision, the elderly ones too should be able to see advanced vision. So beloved, God speaks to His children through vision. Daniel chapter 7.
Daniel,
here you see an experience. Daniel chapter 7.
With Daniel,
I will read verses 1 and 2.
How can I say anything?
Are you there?
Yes, what you mean?
Daniel chapter 7.
With Daniel,
verses 1 and 2.
Yes, anything?
So, in the first year of Belshazzar, king of Babylon, Daniel had a dream.
In Daniel, Lala,
and visions of his head upon his bed. Then he wrote the dream and told the son of the matter. Verse
2.
Daniel spake and said, I saw in my vision by light. And behold, the four winds of the heaven strode upon the great sea. He was sleeping.
Also,
and while he was sleeping, it was as if a drama was taking place. It was a vision. Daniel chapter
8,
verse 2. Daniel also said he saw a vision.
Daniel is not ready to leave, not the
said, and I saw a vision.
What is
the
city?
No, do you know? And it came to pass.
What's the shame? Need that money.
So, beloved, many people do not see vision today because they do not desire it.
Ọ̀pọ̀ ènìyàn ní òní, ìrànlọ́pẹ́ òní, nítorí pé wọn kò fẹ́.
Many people think that it's only the prophets that should get to see the show.
Àti pé àwọn ènìyàn ti gbàgbọ́ wípé àwọn wòlíì nìkan ló yẹ fún láti máa rí ìwé.
You know, many people are not expecting God to speak to them through vision.
Olùfẹ́ ọ̀pọ̀ ní òtí ẹ̀ létí kí Ọlọ́run kó máa bá wọn sọ̀rọ̀ nípa ṣe ìran.
Now that you and I know that vision is one of the avenues of hearing the voice of God.
Ọ̀nà nípa ìlú tí ẹ̀yin àti èmi ti mọ̀ nípa ìtàn lára ọ̀nà tí Ọlọ́run fi ń bá àwọn tí ẹ sọ̀rọ̀ ni.
Desire it.
Ẹ fẹ́.
Pray for it.
Ẹ gbàdúrà fún pẹ̀lú.
Bílọ̀.
Olùfẹ́.
There are different types of visions.
Oríṣi ìran ló wá ń bẹ o.
There are different types of vision.
Oríṣi ìran ní bẹ.
And I will be mentioning four types. In this study.
Most men are orishi men in detective.
Number one,
orishi akoko
is called open vision.
Onoda kini iranṣiṣi.
Open vision.
Iran to ṣi tata sile fun.
What is an open vision?
Kini iranṣiṣi paya sile.
An open vision is the vision you can see.
Iranṣiṣi jẹ iran ti ẹ le ri.
When your physical eyes are open.
Nígbà tí ojú yín wà ní. Kedere ti a oju jura.
And can see both the physical and the spiritual.
Ẹ sì lè rí tààrà ní ti ara àti ní tẹ̀lé.
Your eyes are open.
Ojú yìí là kedere láì díjú.
You are seeing the physical realm.
Ẹ lè rí ní ti ìran tẹ̀lé.
And you are also seeing into the spiritual realm.
Bákan náà ni ẹ ti lè rí lójúkojú pẹ̀lú.
How many of us remember what happened to Elisha?
Ẹni mélòó ni wọn lọ́rùn tí ó tó ṣẹlẹ̀ sí Elisha?
When a whole army came to arrest him.
Nígbà tí àwọn ogun wá láti mú un.
And his servant came out and saw horses and chariots.
Àwọn ọmọ ẹ̀yìn rẹ̀ sì jáde lọ sóde ló bá rí kẹ̀kẹ́ ogun tó yí wọn ká àti ẹṣin.
Do you remember the prayer that Elisha prayed?
Ìyẹn rántí ilú fí àdúrà sí Elisha. Lọ́jọ́ náà sí Ọlọ́run sí
àìmọ́. Oh God, open his eyes.
Àìsàn Ọlọ́run ọbẹ̀ ọ̀ sí ní ojú.
2 Kings 6.
Ìwé àwọn ọba kejì orí kẹfà.
2 Kings 6.
Ìwé àwọn ọba kejì orí kẹfà.
I'm going to read verse 17.
Mo ka ẹsẹ̀ kẹta lé ní ogún.
2 Kings 6.
Ìwé àwọn ọba kejì orí kẹfà.
I'm reading verse 17.
Mo ka ẹsẹ̀ kẹta lé ní ogún.
And Elisha prayed and said.
Elisha sì gbàdúrà ó sì wí pé.
Lord, I pray thee.
Olúwa èyí fẹ́ ọ.
Open his eyes. That he may see.
Kí ó lè rí ràn.
And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man.
Olúwa sì la ojú ọ̀dọ́mọkùnrin náà.
And he saw.
Ó sì rí ràn.
And behold.
Sì wò ó.
The mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire.
Òkè náà kún fún ẹṣin àti kẹ̀kẹ́ iná. Yé
Elisha. About Elisha.
Ó yé Elisha ká.
What the servant of Elisha saw that day.
Ó ti ránṣẹ́ Elisha ní lọ́jọ́ náà.
Was an open vision.
O náà ní ìránṣẹ́ṣẹ́ fire.
Do you want to acquire that ability?
Jẹ́ iná pẹ̀lú fẹ́ ní ìlú fẹ́.
I want you to close your eyes.
Fẹ́ kẹ́ di ojú yìí.
Say, oh God my father.
Ọlọ́run bàbá mi.
Open my eyes.
Ẹ ṣe ojú mi.
The way you open the eyes of the servant of Elisha.
Ní ojú ọ̀nà tí ẹ gbà ṣe ojú ọmọ ìránṣẹ́
ìránṣẹ́. Oh God my father.
Ọlọ́run bàbá mi.
Open my eyes.
Ẹ ṣe ojú mi.
The way you open the eyes of the servant.
Ẹ wọ̀ ní agbára láti rí ìná tẹ̀lé.
Open my eyes, O Lord.
Ẹ ṣe ojú mi ọ̀dọ́rọ̀.
When you open the eyes of
God. Ọlọ́run ti ẹgbà sí ojú ọmọ Elisha.
Amen.
Àmì.
Praise the Lord.
Ẹni Olúwa.
Acts 10.
Ìwé iṣẹ́ àwọn apọ́sẹ̀lì orí kẹwàá.
Acts 10.
Iṣẹ́ àwọn apọ́sẹ̀lì orí kẹwàá.
I'm going to read verse 3.
Wọ́n ka ẹsẹ̀ kẹta.
Acts 10.
Iṣẹ́ àwọn apọ́sẹ̀lì orí kẹwàá.
I'm going to read verse 3.
Mo ka ẹsẹ̀ kẹta.
He was talking of Cornelius.
He
saw in a vision.
Ní wọn wákàtí kẹsàn-án.
Evidently about the night hour of the day.
Ó rí nínú ìran kékeré.
An angel of the Lord coming to him.
Angẹ́lì Ọlọ́run kan wọlé tọ̀ ọ́ wá.
As saying unto him.
Ó sì fi fún pé ọ̀dẹ̀ ń dẹ́wù.
The Lord.
Olùfẹ́.
After this study.
Lẹ́yìn ìkẹ́kọ̀ọ́ yìí.
I pray that every one of us will start to see vision.
Mo gbàdúrà pé kó o wá ọ̀rẹ́ sí ní ìran.
You will start to see not the physical. Was about to be called home.
I bet you not see it.
5 days before the man died.
A young man who saw you in your company.
He was telling the people in his family.
No, I saw one man in there. The people.
He got a sense of India, so.
What you are not now, I'm telling you.
To come and take me home.
That's what happened in the day.
And the people around said, oh, Baba, keep quiet.
And we are not saying, but we came back.
Your spirit.
As if there's
a television inside of you. You may be consciously awake, but you are seeing into your inner man. Acts chapter
16,
verse
9.
Acts chapter 16,
verse 9.
It says, and a vision appeared to Paul in the night. There stood a man of Macedonia, and prayed, saying, come over to Macedonia and
help us. Beloved,
God wants you and I to experience those visions. If anybody tells you that the days of vision are gone, it's a lie. A man of God came to this town some years ago. And one of the things he did was that he will look at you and suddenly tell you, this is the problem you have. And remember, he called out one lady. He said,
you're
about to go to India. And then it was funny. How did you know about
that? Enter
that house. knock at the door.
When you pull it
the man will be there praying.
Oh, you know, oh, but if I think that you are never done.
Direct vision.
You know, that.
Because,
in all of that,
do you want to start with visions?
Yeah, you know, but remember, it's you.
In this day, there are people see visions of angels. Before dangers happen to you, the child of God, God wants to show you the vision. There are some people, God will reveal the visions of their past.
Had a voice saying,
Saul, Saul,
Saul. Jesus, mighty name, I pray.